They might be giants. They might be giants.
They might be bald. They might be snow. They might be Dr. Spock's battle band.
They might be giants. They might be giants.
They might be fake. They might be lies. They might be big, big, fake, fake lies.
Tabloid footprints in your.
Just before we got up here, all the guys were having a fight. Marty was yelling at Danny and John. John threw stuff at Dan. But the anger we felt for each other was kept in our private backstage world. All of our hatred was left behind when we took command of the First Avenue stage.
Everybody, where they might be giants from Brooklyn, New York. How the hell are you? It is very exciting to be here. I just wanted to tell the photographer guy, you can take photographs as long as you want. It's cool. It's totally cool. I mean, I know you probably got to get somewhere else, but it's cool. Flash photography is encouraged. It's great to be here. Thank you so much for coming to this. Was this show rescheduled 4 times? Can't tell.
By the time you hear this, it will be too late.
By the time you hear this, I'll be far away. Moving out at the break of dawn. Moving out past the content pond. All of this time that I missed you, but you weren't missing me. You called it self-improvement.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to begin a celebration. We need to see a sea of hands, people, a sea of hands, because we are going to be performing all of the album Flood tonight. We are going to be performing it both out of sequence and disoriented. But we will get to every single song, even if it means you guys yelling at us at the end of the night. That's the way it works. You know?
We don't make the rules.
Yeah. We don't even really track what we do that carefully. So, here's the first of all 19 songs. And when I say 19, do I mean 18? How many songs are
there? Or something.
Yeah, something. Maybe 17. 17. But the first album had 19, the second album...
They're saying, people are yelling 19.
19. Well, there better be 19 songs on it, for Christ's sake.
Right.
We've been waiting 2.5 years to do this show.
I think, yeah. I think there's 17 good songs, put it that way.
Okay. All right. Enough chit-chat. Back to the music. Or we can talk.
Ooh.
Flood, flood, flood. Everybody likes it. That was a song that didn't make the album.
Yeah, Elektra's been trying to get that release on a rarities, you know. They were going to add a second disc just for that. And we were like, no way, man. You got to hear the demo of that.
That's right. It's unbelievable. So how you doing, Flansburgh?
I'm doing good. Did the photographer leave already? He left. Left? He's gone? If the photographer wants to take photos from the back, he can shoot this way. It's really impressive. The crowns are very effective tonight. It really amplifies the head bobbing aspect of the music that we perform. I feel like, you know, a little bit of a, what was the, you know, the bass player in Metallica, the, you know, the middle guy in Metallica. It's like a little taste of that, the wiggle. I guess his hair didn't wiggle, but I don't know. It didn't. It did a thing. Okay, so what's
here's next? Another song from the Flood album.
All right.
Everybody likes the album Flood. That was the reprise. Okay, here we go.
Bye.
Thank you. Twisting in the Wind. From the album Flood.
It's a celebration. Yeah. Oh, John, something broke?
Yeah, I don't know.
Wow. Sounds it's like the story of our lives. Yeah, I saw their show. Something fucked up.
We like to call attention to it, though.
Right.
It's part of our charm. It's
yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, I fucked up that yeah. song.
Those
everybody.
Guys, they really make it look hard.
Yes.
John, do you want to wait till it works, or does it just not matter?
It's not a critical problem.
Why don't we just turn the
but
video...
But I'd like to introduce Mr. John Brunette
yeah.
here.
Right.
He is the guy who makes stuff happen.
On the lam from the New Orleans Police for 20 years.
Let's get the video camera on so we can bask in the glory that is the thing not working. There we go. John, maybe
I'm saying the word signal chain.
Maybe if I put my mic on it, it would work. Is it?
It's doing a thing.
I think it's working now.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Signal chain.
Signal chain. Signal chain to musicians is like supply chain. To your mom.
Yes, exactly. Well, like I said, this is not a critical thing. We can move on.
Yeah,
I'm just enjoying this technical jargon.
Okay. All right.
Here's another song from the Flood album.
This is where the party ends. I'll just sit here wondering how you can stand by your ace's friend. I know politics for you, but I feel like a hypocrite talking to you. You and your ace's friend.
It was the loveliest party that I've ever attended. If anything was broken, I'm sure it could be mended. My head is tired from this bobbing and pretending. Listen to some bullet head and the madness that he's saying. This is where the party ends. I can't stand here listening to you.
It's time to introduce the horns. That's Stan Harrison on the saxophone, Dan Levine on the trombone, and Mark Pender on the trumpet. And of course, joining us also on the bandstand is Mr. Marty Beller on the drums. God damn it, he's come to hear you scream. Danny Weinkauf on the bass, Dan Miller on the electric guitar. My name's John, his name's John. You guys in the audience.
All right, I think we're all accounted for now.
Yes. And the rest. Here we go.
They built this whole neighborhood out of wood, out of wood. I guess I'll still be around when they burn, burn it down. I will be standing around when they burn it down. Here in the Museum of Idiots. Honey, I'm there when you need me. Please believe me. Please believe me. I'll still be right where you left me if you manage to forget me. Where we met is where you may forget. Here in the Museum of Chop me up into pieces, if it pleases, if it pleases. When the chopping is through, every piece will say, I love you.
Museum
of Idiots.
Thank you. Check what album that's on.
Museum of Idiots?
The Spine. It's on the album The Spine. Available somewhere for right. Money.
If there were record stores.
That's right.
A woman came up to me and said, I'd like to poison your mind. Wrong ideas that appeal to you, though I am not unkind. She looked at me, I looked at something written across her scalp. These are the words that it faintly said as I tried to call for help. There's only one thing that I know how to do well, and I've often been told that you only can do what you know how to do well, and that's for you. Be what you're like, be like yourself. Whistling in the dark, 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 whistling in the dark. There's only one thing that I like, and that is whistling in the dark. A man came up to me and said, I'd like to change your mind. By hitting it with a rock, he said, though I am not unkind.
ever been told that you only can do what you know how to do well, and that's be you. Be what you like, be like yourself. So I'm having a wonderful time, but I'd rather be whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. There's only one thing that I like, and that is whistling in the dark. And there's only one thing that I know how to do well, and I've often been told that you only can do what you know how to do well, and that's be you. Be what you're like, be like yourself. And so I'm having a wonderful time, but I'd rather be whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, 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 whistling, whistling, whistling in the dark.
Linnell, when you started speeding up in the second verse, I thought you were going to keep on speeding up.
No,
it was going to be like the best show ever.
Tempting.
It was like, wow, Linnell took
tempting.
Off. No compromises.
And then I hit the rumble strips.
Yeah. And everything suddenly...
And everyone's like, we're going to die!
It might happen. We're playing in St. Paul tomorrow night.
Right.
It could happen. I'm not promising.
We have a number of songs that have like like a retard at the end where, you know, and it's not a set thing. Like sometimes it's slightly different, and sometimes it gets so slow that it seems like the song might not end.
Yes.
And there's this one. It's just like.
Yes.
And then. It does end.
That's right. That could also happen tomorrow night.
But I don't know. I think the speeding it up thing could be exciting. Like it would be so unexpected to just start playing it a whole lot faster. I don't know. It's an idea. We've been playing this album a lot. So anyway.
A lot of ideas.
A lot of ideas. Here we go. Here's a song called Dr. Worm.
Play the drums.
I'm interested in things. I'm not a real doctor, but I
some high notes.
The Horns have their non-union recognized three-song break. You know, ladies and gentlemen, we have about, I guess, 35 shows ahead of us where we are doing this special Music Under Glass presentation of Flood. And so, of course, the discussion, self-sabotage being job one of any real rock band, we thought, what can we do to make it harder on ourselves? And how about performing a song sonically backwards for once? Which brings us to this next portion of our performance. We're going to perform the song Sapphire Bullets of Pure Love. A song that we thought would be interesting to perform backwards. We didn't recognize at first that it would be also difficult to perform backwards. But what's satisfying is not the effort, is not the struggle, it's the medium to good quality results, which we will be broadcasting at the beginning of the second set. I forgot to mention that we're doing two sets tonight. One good set, and we're breaking for a really long time and coming back with a really short set of songs you don't like as much. But let's get back to the music. John, do you have your iPhone speech?
I've got my cheat sheet because I'm going to be introducing the song. Because we're playing it backwards, I'll be introducing it at the end. Because that's how we do this. And the other thing is, we're going to ask you, not yet, but in a moment, we're going to ask you to applaud as if you've already heard the song. And then I'm going to conduct so that you stop. Yeah. Just right before Marty begins / finishes playing the song. We're
going to call upon you to do some super confident fake applause. But yes. Not yet. But, you know, we know you guys have got a solid background in the theater. So this won't be hard. All right. So here we go.
This is how it goes. I will conduct. Watch me. Still a breakfast, nost a skensith for meaneth. Okay.
So.
That was the hard part.
You'll see this when the video happens in the second set, but the weird thing about singing a song backwards is like, that sounds backwards, but then when you play it back the other way, it still sounds backwards.
Yes.
Except for the parts where it's like, Satan, join us.
Right. Which everybody hears loud and clear. Yeah. And I hope takes to heart, too. A few times when we're actually sincere up here, but. So here's a song about traveling into the future so that you can murder your future self. Draw the curtain, look, you're only sleeping. Or is this only what the other you is dreaming? Either way, hard to take. Ashen features, unmistakably your own. Familiar posture, recast in skin and bone. Person from today, here is you in 2082. Remove your helmet, first equalize the pressure. No, but first take readings to be sure the atmosphere is safe. Yes, it's safe. As the ancient one cranes his neck to look, you
You see his hand's been replaced with a hook, but it's clear you're very much alive. It's 2105. No, it's 2340. No, it's 2815. How can you still be living? What does this mean? You must honor and respect the older fellow, even as you suffocate him with his pillow. Though you're strong, he was wise. There is much you can learn from the sage, and though you leave and travel back to your own age, you will meet again, you two, in 2082. What was the look he gave intended to convey? Was there something else he was trying to say? It will all be revealed to you in 2082.
We've got a brand new album out. It's called Book. It's also a book, as well as an 8-track and a cassette and a vinyl album. And this is the opening song on the album.
For everyone who only just arrived, a quick synopsis. If you came late and missed the commotion, you wonder what was all that. Here's the recap. Sound of gathering and shuffling of notes. I assure you there's a very simple explanation.
lost in your thoughts. Who ate the babies? Who ate the babies? All we can say right now is that we're taking all conceivable protective means to secure this area, in particular with reference to the worrisome volcano that emerged beneath us overnight. That's all the questions that time will permit. I'm afraid we'll have to leave it right there. Be assured that there's nothing more that can be done. That's all the questions that time will permit. I'm afraid we'll have to leave it right there. Be assured that there's nothing more that can be done. Doodly 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 do.
We got one more song for this first set. We want to thank you so much for coming out to the show. We want to remind you that all the profits from the They Might Be Giants t-shirt sold tonight will go to the They Might Be Giants Integrity Defense Fund that was started over 30 years by the guys who started the band. We don't know them, but we've been told that they're super cool guys. Here's our set ender.
Thank you. should be waiting in Istanbul. Even old New York was once New Amsterdam. Why they changed it, I can't say.
People just liked it better that way.
Go back to Constantinople.
No, you can't go back to Constantinople.
Been a long time gone, Constantinople. Why did Constantinople get the works?
That's nobody but the Turks.
The Turks!
Istanbul, even old New York was once New Amsterdam. Why they changed it, I can't say.
People just liked it better that way.
So take me back to Constantinople.
No, we can't go back to Constantinople.
Been a long time gone, Constantinople.
Constantinople get the works.
That's nobody's business but the
bit. This next song is a fabulous of mirror love.
She can, but she won't, cause she's highly qualified and she's not a joke. When it comes to opera, she is ossified. So all of the opera's better, super sad. When my friend got amnesia, she can't remember the show she saw. Like the one with the guy with amnesia who got off of the island on the hill.
I know a natural dancer with a big fan. She's a natural dancer. She calls and she laughs and she makes a lot of calls. And all of the people applaud. And she's a star.
Thank you.
When the ship runs out of ocean, when the vessel runs aground, lands where we know the boat is found. Now there's nothing unexpected but the water giving out. Land's not a word we have to shout, but there's something beside the shoreline, coming up from the beach and making up from the ship. Of love, and everywhere they go, love will grow.
Women and men.
When you see the faces on the women and the men, you too will know.
Women and men cross the ocean, they now begin to pour out from the boat and up the shore. Two by two, the end of the jungle, and soon they number more. Three by three is
very much. Movie Phone. Let's bring those horn players back here for another song off the album Flood.
All right, Marty, you got that sound ready? Wait, does Marty do the sound or do
Marty's
you do
doing
the sound?
Sound, yeah.
Marty does it?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, and oh, John, is that thing working?
I don't know.
Okay. Okay.
Yes. The answer is yes.
Just wanted to make sure. I didn't want to get too far into the show without knowing.
No, I know. We'll check it right before. This is good that we have this band meeting now, because we never see each other except when we're on stage together. We're like Fleetwood Mac. Basically. Yeah. We get to talk about, you know, how are your cats, John?
Right. Well, my cats are doing okay.
Okay, one of them's getting old now.
Yeah, right? One of them's super old. We leave from different parts of the bus when we get here. I come out the exhaust pipe. Yeah. John makes me. He thinks the discipline will make me stronger. I disagree. So here's a song off the album. And it's called Hot Shot. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment I have all been waiting for,
We're going to perform a song now. The chart was put together with Mr. Stan Harrison, our saxophone player tonight. And this is a song, it's about the undead. And it's called The Darlings of Lumberland. Thank you very much. Mr. Dan Miller, everybody. Dan Miller on the keyboards. And the Maurice Gibb harmony of that song.
Yes. Exactly.
Who's Barry in this equation?
I think you were Barry.
No, I think you're
no,
Barry.
I'm singing this. I'm singing this. I'm singing the super fake high part.
Exactly.
So that makes me Barry.
Barry.
You got to know your Gibb brothers' vocal roles, because Robin was the one who sang in sort of the emotional falsetto.
That's me.
Yeah. Robin Gibb.
I'm totally Robin. I don't have the thing with his teeth, but
there's room for improvement.
I know. I'll see my orthodontist.
All right. Hold on. There appears to be a pick.
All right.
Here we go.
Two, three, four.
Particle man, doing the things a particle can. What's he like? It's not important. Particle man, is he a dot or is he a speck? When he's underwater, does he get wet? Or does the water get him instead? Nobody knows. Particle man. Particle man, they have a fight. Triangle wins. Triangle man. Universe man, universe man, size of the entire universe man, usually kind to smaller man. Universe man, he's got a watch with a minute hand. Millennium hand. It's a happy land, powerful man, universe man. Person man, hit on the head with a frying pan, lives his life in a garbage can. Person man, is he depressed or is he a mess? Does he feel totally worthless? Who came up with person man, degraded man?
For the planet, to the planet, Venus, triangle man, take off for the planet, to the planet, Venus, triangle man, take off for the planet, to the planet, Venus, triangle man, take off for the planet, to the planet, Venus!
Rick, John's going to play the keys on this one. I indicated it wrong on the set list.
What happened?
I wrote that you played accordion on the next song, and I just, it's quite explicitly wrong, and I just wanted Rick to know that. Just play the keyboard for a second, just make sure you got it, because I don't want to.
Okay, good. Keep Rick on his toes.
Yeah. No. There'll be no toe keeping. All the toes must go.
I lost my lucky mama Jane. Now she's 40 years gone. She's 5 feet tall and sick of me and all my rattling on. She threw away her baby doll. I held on to my pride, but I was young and foolish then. I feel old and foolish now. Confidentially, she never called. We'll be right back.
Confidentially, I never told you of her charm. Confidentially, we never had a car. But this railroad apartment was the perfect place when she said, I'm only a lost my lucky ball and chain. Now she's 4 years gone. She's 5 feet tall and sick of me.
You know, I feel like for years and years we carried confetti cannons, and then later on we had a confetti machine, and which is just a thing that can like churn out confetti continuously, and you know, just like as these individual pieces of confetti drop, I'm just thinking, I feel like it's like the revenge of,
yeah,
you know, all the bands that had to come after us, witnessing the same thing, just like. You know,
doesn't matter how interesting anything else on stage right, is at right, that moment.
Right.
It's like all attention is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's a little karmic payback for us tonight. I do have to say that sometimes I feel like I just have like the mind of a dog when I. You know, so here's a song we like to do. It's called. Let me tell you, people, about the we'll be right back.
drag. The horns, ladies and gentlemen. Dan Levine. Mark Pender.
Stan Harrison.
All on the First Avenue stage.
You're older than you've ever been, and now you're even older, and now you're even older, and now you're even older. You're older than you've ever been, and now you're even older, and now you're older still. Time is marching on, and time
Oh, hold on, I gotta get this. It's gonna be a second, sorry. Hello, you've reached They Might Be Giants. Who's calling, please?
Hello.
Hello?
John?
Yes, this is John of They Might Be Giants.
This is Papa TMBG.
Papa TMBG?
Yeah.
The father of all the members of TMBG?
That's right.
Papa.
Doing?
We are doing great since you called.
That's good to hear.
It's great to hear your voice.
I'm watching this live feed of your show.
You sound fantastic.
You sound fantastic.
No.
You.
No.
You. Ah, John. I like the major label music okay. But I really like the indie rock the best.
I understand.
Can you play some old songs?
No. No, we got our own thing now. Papa, They Might Be Giants is still marching on. This day will soon be at an end, and now it's even sooner. And now it's even sooner, and now it's even sooner. This day will soon be at an end, and now it's even sooner, and now it's sooner still. And now you're even older, and now you're even older. You're older than you've ever been, and now you're even older, and now you're older still.
Minimum wage.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. So, Flans, you missed it. Papa, they might be giants, called us while we were on stage. He sounded terrible. He sounded like he was...
I'm sorry, but...
Like, I don't know what happened. He sounded sick.
Sorry to hear that.
But I told him he sounded great. And
well, that's good.
I think he believed me.
It's important to lie to your relatives, especially around holiday time.
Especially on holiday.
Remember that, people.
Yes.
That's the most important time to lie.
Yeah.
We've been lying to our father. We played in a hockey rink recently, and it sounded atrocious, but it was the first time we ever felt completely at home playing this next song, which goes like this. The pro is here to lead the way, to save the day. Wicked little critter. He clips the puck from Bobby Orr. He shoots, he scores. Wicked little critter. As he proceeds to scorch the place. As he proceeds to scorch the place. As he proceeds to torch the place. Torture, 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 wicked little critter. He's a wicked little critter with a sissy bar, and he lays a patch on the dime. He's a wicked little critter with a sissy bar, and he lays a patch on the dime. Then he bumps a wheelie on his mini bike, and he burns rubber and he peels out. He's a wicked little critter with a sissy bar, and he lays a patch on the dime. And he clips the ball from Havlicek, and Havlicek is used and abused. He's a wicked little critter with a sissy bar, and he decides to ditch and he ditches, and nobody knows to where he ditched. He's a wicked little critter with a sissy bar, and he lays a patch on the top. He's a wicked little guy. He's a wicked little guy. He's a wicked little guy. He's a wicked little critter.
Wicked little critter.
He's a dink. Way to go. I like him. I got problems. You know, I gotta say, for some reason, I changed one of the lyrics in that song, and what it is he decides to ditch and he ditches, and I changed it to, and nobody knows to where he ditched, because you can't end a sentence on a preposition. So I feel like it's the kind of uptight, you know, prescriptive grammar nonsense that our audience just loves. You guys are so into that.
I think we should go out to Ruth's, Chris's, Steak's houses
and celebrate.
Celebrate.
You know, or if we're not wanting to spend a lot of money, we could go to Carl's Junior. Carl's. Carl has a Junior.
Carl's is Junior's is hamburgers.
Yes. But Ruth's, Chris's Steakhouse also is it's very possessive.
Yeah. It's that. That possessive apostrophe is holding on by dear life.
You guys are holding conversations with us, and we can't hear what you're saying.
We're talking to Al Gore.
Yeah, we're hearing Al Gore in our earpieces, and he's saying, "Don't listen to the people in the audience. They think they're talking to you.
They're not erudite enough, or rich enough, for me, the relatable vice president."
Yes.
I just lost my mind. I'm sorry.
You know, it kind of drives you crazy to have Al Gore in your ear for the whole show.
Well, it's better than
Start
Ross
to go
Perot.
Crazy.
That's the other frequency, Ross Perot.
Okay. There you go.
All right. I returned a bag of groceries accidentally taken off the shelf before the expiration date. I came back as a bag of groceries accidentally taken off the shelf before the debt stemmed on myself. Did a large procession wave their torches as my head fell in the basket, and was everybody dancing on the casket? Now it's over, I'm dead, and I haven't done anything that I want, or I'm still alive and there's nothing I want to do. I will never say the word procrastinate again. I'll never see myself in the mirror with my eyes closed. I didn't apologize for when I was 8 and I made my younger brother have to be my personal slave. Did a large procession wave their torches as my head fell in the basket, and was everybody dancing on the casket? Now it's over, I'm dead, and I haven't done anything that I want, or I'm still alive and there's nothing I want to do. So I won't sit at home anymore, and you won't see my head in the window.
Gee whiz. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to introduce the band to you one more time. On the saxophone, that's Mr. Stan Harrison. Marty, Danny, give us some kind of musical sounds. On the electric guitar, all the way from Brooklyn, he took the subway. It's Mr. Dan Miller, everybody. On the trombone, Dan the Machine Levine. On the trumpet, direct from the television in your mind, it's Mr. Mark the Love Man Pender. My name's John, his name's John, you're the audience. That's Danny Wonkoff on the bass, everybody. But most of all people, the only man sitting on a throne, it's a drum throne, because he's the king of the drums. His name is Marty Beller, and he's coming to New York City to hear you scream. We sure want to thank you all for coming to the show. We are playing in St. Paul tomorrow. This is the time where you guys go boo. I shouldn't have imposed that on you. I'm sorry. I apologize. Thank you, Marty. I'm sorry about that. You know, I realize, of course, like people here, you guys are like, it's like Cambridge and Boston. You guys are in love with St. Paul, probably. We've been traveling around so much, and everywhere we go, we'll just be, you know, we'll mention the name of another city, and people will just start booing, and we're so used to it now. We just don't, and we sort of had to like draw a line in the sand where they started booing New York City, because it was like, hey, we're from New York City. You can't boo where we're from. But anyway, folks, we've got two more songs for the price of one. Here we go.
Why is the world in love again? Why are we marching hand in hand? Why are the ocean levels rising up? It's a brand new record for 1990. They might be giants. But really, I'm not actually your friend, but I am. But really, I'm not actually your friend, but I am. There's a picture opposite me of a primitive ancestry which stood on rocky shores and kept the beaches shipwreck free. Now I respect that a lot. I've been fighting that on my job after killing, chasing off, and countless screaming Argonauts. Who put a friendliness like guardian angels? It's always near. Looking there in the alley with a light switch. Who watches over you? Make a little birdhouse in your soul. Not to put too fine a point on. Put too fine a point on it. Say I'm the only bee in your body. Make a little birdhouse in your cell.
You've been a fantastic audience. Thank you so much.
I met someone at the dog show. She was holding my left arm, but everyone was acting normal, so I tried to look nonchalant. We both said, I really love you. The Shriners loaned us cars. We raced up and down the sidewalk 20,000 million times. I'm gonna speak to the man in charge. The secretary says he's on another line. Can I hold for a long, long time? I found out she's an angel. I don't think she knows I know. I'm worried that something might happen to me if anyone ever finds out.
Thank you so much. This next song was written and recorded by a band from Vancouver called Cub. It's called New York City.
You called me last night on the telephone, and I was glad to hear from you, 'cause I was all alone. You said, it's snowing, it's snowing. God, I hate this weather. Now I walk through blizzards just to get us back together.
Yeah.
Flancy, we heard you were out here.
I just followed the horns.
That was a mistake.
Yeah. So you guys, seriously, you guys are awesome. Thank you so much. All you guys, those people. Is there anyone else? People back there? People behind the glass up there? What the hell, man?
Yeah. It's like they're at a hockey game.
Yeah. So here's a song called When Will You Die? So tired of your lies and the evil things you do behind my back, all the crimes that you have never committed. Out and sometimes I wonder when will you die. You're insane, you are bad, you wreck everything you've done, and you're a sociopath. This is one thing that everyone's wondering: when will you die? School children stay at home, and all the banks will collude. But the one remaining piece of the puzzle, which is when you'll die. This is Dan, and that's Danny, and there's Marty on the drums to complete the band, and I'm John, and he is also John, and all of us are wondering when you're gonna die. Morning, we will wake and greet the dawn, knowing that your wicked life is over and that we will carry on. We'll exhale, we'll high five, we will know it was how great it is to be alive. We'll be lining up and buying tickets, and then we'll be jumping up and down on your grave. You're insane, you are bad. So long.
Have a great night.
Thanks again.